who's the market manager for South Asia for the University of Waikato, which is based in New Zealand. Ashish has been with the industry for over 10 years now. And today he's given us the chance to have him on our platform and speak with you all and cater to all your queries and also let you know what opportunities are available for international students in New Zealand. Over to you, Ashish.
Thank you, Tanya, and thank you, IDP India, for this opportunity to interact with students about New Zealand, kind of a destination which is niche in its nature and unique by itself. Kia ora, namaste to all these students who are attending this session this afternoon. The Connect About New Zealand aligns with what makes New Zealand unique. There are a few factors which makes New Zealand unique. To start with that, I think it's very important for you all to understand that we were one of the first countries in the world to introduce the code of pastoral care, which is the safety of international students. Given the dynamic world we all are living in, it's very important that the student's safety is essential and how they align with the local people in the country. And New Zealand is a leader in the student welfare. We're also ranked second most peaceful country in the world. And currently, we just got among the top 10 countries in the happiest index as well, which is also a reflection and an indication of how the quality of work-life balance is maintained in New Zealand. So as international students, if you are aspiring to look at study destination overseas, safety, quality of work-life balance, career plan, and the opportunity to work in any of those countries become some of the key factors before you decide to select a destination of your choice. We're also very well ranked in terms of employability. So ranked amongst the top 7 for the highest performing graduates, even ahead of countries like US, Canada, and England. And the best part about New Zealand is that it has only public universities, and all 8 public universities of New Zealand are ranked amongst the top 3% in the world. As an international student, we believe it's not only about thinking out of the box, we also say think in the box, and that's why we also are ranked among the top 10 out of the 135 nations for creativity as well. So when you are looking for a destination to study, it's not only about looking at its closeness, but also looking at how creative, unique its ranking and its focus on employability for international graduates is, which makes country a popular choice for international students. Before I jump into slides which connects you about qualifications, career opportunities, and post-study work rights within New Zealand for international students, it's always good to have a glimpse of the New Zealand as a country alongside the presentation.
Welcome to the country of open spaces. Where nature bursts and flows. Where the elements come alive. Where there is room to breathe. Places to find. Welcome to the country of open hearts. Where care for the land and people is genuine. Where life is for living. Time spent together is never time wasted. where lasting partnerships are formed. Where strangers are treated as friends. And memories are treasured forever. Welcome to the country of open minds. Where learning is embraced. And opinions valued. Where freshness is championed. And quality prized. For the world to enjoy. Where nature inspires incredible thinking. Where ingenuity drives innovation. And productivity. Where big ideas are born every day. And new technologies are perfected. Where the impossible becomes real. And where every sunrise inspires the extraordinary. Welcome to the country of open spaces, open hearts, and open minds. Together, we can do amazing things.
I'm sure that would have given you a good glimpse about New Zealand as a destination, not only in terms of higher education, but we also focus a lot of on innovation and contribution to the global world as well. Now, there are 8 universities in New Zealand, which are segmented into the North Island and South Island of the country. If you look at the North Island out there, there are universities like Victoria University of Wellington, which is located in the capital city of New Zealand, University of Waikato, wherein I represent four, which is in Hamilton, the fourth largest city of New Zealand. There is University of Auckland, which is located in the largest commercial city of New Zealand. There is Auckland University of Technology, which is also located in Auckland. And there is Massey University, which is located in Palmerston North, again in North Island. The other 3 universities, the Lincoln University, the University of Canterbury, and University of Otago, are located in South Island. The best part about each of the New Zealand universities is its alignment, not only to cater to the international students, but its location also ensures that each university has domestic and the diverse set of international students on campus, which aligns very strongly with international students that you are mostly studying in each of the universities, which have a culturally diverse student community. So you not only learn in New Zealand, but you also become a global citizen as well, which is a very important skill set for an international student. Looking at some of the very popular qualifications, I have streamlined it into areas which each of these universities are known for. So if you are looking to study courses in engineering, civil, or computer science, or in area of international business and law, you can always look forward to secure your admits around at the University of Auckland. If you're looking to get into aviation and want to get into a commercial pilot, Massey is one of the only universities in New Zealand which offers a course in aviation. And they're also very good for veterinary and food technologies as well. Lincoln is always known as an agri or a land-based uni. So if you're looking for opportunities to get into viticulture, food and wine science, if you look at landscape architecture, very unique set of courses, but kind of very popular because if you look at the demography of New Zealand, we always evolved as an agri and a dairy business economy. World's best cheese, milk products, they all get exported from New Zealand across the world as of today as well. If you're looking for courses in hospitality, tourism, or computer, or towards health sciences, you can look forward to pursue your qualifications with Auckland University of Technology. University of Otago is the one which also has the dentistry school on campus. So it offers courses in dentistry, psychology, neurosciences, and also courses in the field of medicine along with University of Auckland. If you're looking to pursue your courses in artificial intelligence, cybersecurity, climate change, or in areas of supply chain management, then you should look at University of Waikato, because the business school at Waikato is also ranked number one in New Zealand for business and economics qualifications as well. Victoria University of Wellington is known for its programs in architecture or design and biomedical sciences and in the area of humanities as well. So if you, any one of you have an opportunity to get into liberal arts or into architecture, you can look forward to pursue your qualifications with them. And Canterbury is known as an engineering university. If you're looking for any of the engineering courses or in the area of data science, then University of Canterbury is excellent for those set of subject areas. These are not the only subject areas each of the university in New Zealand offers. There's a diversity of subject areas, but to make it easy for you to align yourself with the university, these are some of the very popular courses each of the New Zealand universities offer under its subset at the campuses. Now, life in a classroom is very different to what you experience in India, where you are more driven by subject knowledge, where you are more driven by into a bookish way of a taught learning process. But when you come over to New Zealand, you are more put into the practical stuff from the day one you start your courses. If you look at carefully, you are taken into farms and vineyards. If you're doing a course in viticulture, so you're actually experiencing to taste the wine every day. We don't want you to taste it, but we want you to learn the taste of it, how it aligns, and you are able to identify a wine tasting as a skill set. If you're studying a design course, you majorly do most of your practical work with the design labs at each of the universities. If you're picking up a science course, we take you to practical stuff outdoor. So what do we, in a one word, we say is your weekend playground is our weekday classroom. So you might go to a playground to play only over the weekends, or go over in some of those weekends to play a sport. But every day we take you out as part of the classroom activities and learning outcomes. And that's why we say your weekend playground is your weekday classroom. And most of your qualifications are very hands-on and practical situational-based learning, where you are put into situations, you're put into caselets, and are aligned to come out with thoughts, which leads you to a constructive decision-making depending on the subject area you have decided to choose for your higher studies. With reference to entry requirements, which are very critical for international students, if you are coming to a New Zealand university for an undergraduate courses, we do accept all the state boards in India. So if you're from a national board, you need to have a minimum 75% in your class 12. And if you're coming from a state board from India, you need to have a minimum of 80% as well. Given the emergence of the international baccalaureate curriculum in India, we do get a lot of students coming in from the IB background, and you do have an opportunity, if you score a minimum of 24 points, to apply for the courses at universities. 24 points doesn't mean you will be able to get into it, but it also marginalizes you with the opportunity to apply. The good thing with New Zealand and with universities in New Zealand is all your entries are very academic driven. So you don't need to sit for any of the competitive examinations. You don't need to give a SAT or a GRE or a GMAT. If you're very good with your academic scores, either at your high school level or at your graduate level, you can straight away apply for any of the universities to study for your higher education. Look at the requirements at the postgraduate level. So if you're looking for a master's degree or a postgraduate diploma, you need to have a bachelor's degree with a cognate major with a B or B+, which will translate around 58% with the Indian higher education system if you're looking from a percentage perspective as well. And if you're looking for a postdoctoral stuff, we expect you to have a master's degree as well with a B+. A very important point here is for all these students who decide to look at an opportunity to be in New Zealand, your academic score is the most important criteria for the admit with one of the New Zealand universities. This slide gives you an indication about the timeline for your applications. And one very important thing, there are no application fees to apply with New Zealand universities, which is a kind of a money saver. So if you decide to apply, you can apply with the universities and there are no application fee for international students. If you're looking to start, generally the intakes with New Zealand are down in Feb and July. So we are located in the southern hemisphere of the world. So if you're planning to start in July, you could start your applications with the start of February, get everything sorted, apply for your scholarships, and then come over to apply for visa in May to ensure you make it for July. If you intend to start for next year, February, September is the best time for you to target for your applications to happen. Do your research well, apply, then have your offer letters, scholarships, apply visa, and then have a turnaround time to arrive on campus by Jan so that you can start your studies in Feb. So this slide gives you an indication that if you decide to look at New Zealand as an option for your study destination, you should plan it 4 to 6 months in advance, which ensures that you have sufficient time in hand to ensure your application is well received, time for scholarships, and you have good amount of time to apply for a student visa and then come over to any of the universities in New Zealand. I'm sure scholarships are a very important factor for a student journey when you decide on your applications and acceptances. And good thing is each of the New Zealand universities are very generous with scholarship opportunities for international students. So if you look at very carefully, University of Auckland or a Massey University offers around 10 to 15,000 New Zealand dollars of scholarship. Lincoln and AUT have a similar amount of scholarships as well. And similarly, University of Otago or a Waikato, Victoria, Canterbury, we do again offer good amount of scholarships, which range between 10 to 15,000 New Zealand dollars for an academic year. The best part about these scholarships, again, these are merit-based scholarships. So depending on how well you do in your undergraduate degree or how well you do in your high school grades at your high school level, have a direct impact on the scholarship. Each university has its own process of applying for a scholarship. So when you decide to apply to New Zealand, you can't have one common application. You'll have to apply with each university separately. And if you receive your offer letter, then you can apply for your scholarship application separately as well with any of the New Zealand universities with whom you have secured an offer letter for your higher studies. I think over the last 12 minutes, we've been talking about qualifications, scholarships, about New Zealand. But what makes a student journey very enriching in a country like New Zealand is careers. Because when you decide to choose a destination, it is very important for you to look at, does that destination have organizations? Does this destination have opportunities for international students to work part-time or full-time? And I think the next three slides answer that question for you, that when you are looking at New Zealand, there are ample amount of career opportunities available for international students to explore, which not only aligns with industries, which could be agri, dairy business, tourism, or service-based, but there is a diverse set of opportunities for international students to work in New Zealand. And the most of the qualifications at universities would have an internship component. And that's a very good element that when you choose to do a master's program or an undergraduate degree, universities do have an internship and there are career service department to ensure that you are not only aligned with the industry, but you're also told and showed a path how to prepare your curriculum vitae, how a resume should look at, in a New Zealand environment, which could be very different the way it's here in India. So the other big advantage for you is each of the universities have career services department, which sits down on your one-to-one session, guide you on how to approach the people in New Zealand and how to engage with the community as well. The other good thing with universities is, as I said, there are internship opportunities, but each university also has a regional body, which also works very closely with the employers community in New Zealand, and regional bodies support international students to ensure that their job opportunities are created irrespective of the kind of courses you plan to do in the country. Just to highlight some of the skills which are in demand, and that has seen a lot of international students to look at career opportunities. So construction is definitely in very high demand. If you're coming up for courses, which leads you to opportunities to get into quantity surveying, project manager, project builder, aligns you immediately with a skill which is in high demand. Engineering is a technical, but a skill, again, very high demand in New Zealand and across all subject areas. I have just picked in very few of them there, but engineering overall is across the board in New Zealand. Medical and health service professionals, it says IT profession, we always say at ICT, if you look at it very carefully, which is information, communication and technology, it's amongst the top 8 sectors in demand for international students to come in and contribute. And look at the job areas. You can get into software developer. You can be a business analyst, project manager, support engineer. So if you're coming with an ICT background or a qualification relevant to the area of ICT, there are tremendous amount of job opportunities for you in New Zealand. Again, New Zealand being very strong in R&D, research and development. And that's why we said open spaces, open minds and creative thinking. A lot of opportunities in the area of science subject areas as well, not only limiting it to a food technologist or environment scientist, there are opportunities in the area of molecular and cellular biology, for example. There are opportunities to pick up courses in environment sciences, ecology, biodiversity, and environment planning as well. Teachers, accountants are also some of the other areas which are, I would say, are some of the other skills which are in high demand across board in New Zealand. This slide gives you a very quick snapshot about how well connected each of the New Zealand universities are with the industry. So you'd not only look at companies which you have heard of, from a Bank of New Zealand to an ANZ to a PricewaterhouseCoopers to an Ernst & Young, but you also look at government organizations. There is Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment. There is Reserve Bank of New Zealand. There is Treasury. There is Fonterra, which is the New Zealand's largest dairy farm company and world's third largest. There is Air New Zealand. There is Audit New Zealand. So there's a diverse set of opportunities which are available for international students to work in New Zealand, which could be either in the form of a part-time work or it could be in the form of a full-time work opportunity as well. This is a very important aspect of a student journey, and that's about opportunities and the work rights. So if you are looking to come in for a qualification to on a student visa, then international students are allowed to work 20 hours in a week. And while you have your scheduled vacations, your trimester's break, there's a Christmas break, then you can work full time as well as an international student. And the current wage rate has gone up from 1st April. Now it's 22.70 New Zealand dollars per hour, which is a good sufficient amount of money and resources to ensure you can take care of your living expenses. And that can also support you your journey of focusing yourself on study and balancing out your expenses while you are there in New Zealand on a student visa. As I said, post-study work rights are very, very important for a student journey, because when you finish your qualification and you want to gain an international exposure to yourself, you need to make those connections with the industry. You need to gain those skills, which not only give you an opportunity to learn, but also give you an opportunity to work across the world. So New Zealand has a very stable post-study work rights. If you are doing your master's and doctoral programs from any of the universities, you are eligible for a three-year open post-study work visa. So if you do a one-year master's program, you will be able to stay back in New Zealand for 3 years. And this is an open post-study work visa, which means there are no preconditions to it. The only precondition is you need to successfully complete your qualification. So you need to pass your qualification to be eligible for a three-year open post-study work visa. And that goes for bachelor's degrees as well. So again, if you are doing a bachelor's degree and you finish your course, you could be in New Zealand for up to 6 years, 3 years for your course of study and 3 years on an open post-study work, right? And that's phenomenal. Because I think that's a good amount of time, not only for you to feel the sector, not only for you to learn and experience, but also good amount of time to see, can you align yourself in that cultural community in New Zealand and have an opportunity for seeing long-term careers as well. And students, there are courses which are listed in green list. So if you're picking up courses which are part of the green list, which are non-degree level 7 graduate diploma ones, then you will be eligible for a 1 year of an open post-study work visa. It's not only about studying in New Zealand. When you decide to choose your higher studies, I'm sure you are also very confident to look at, does New Zealand universities gives you opportunity that it does not limit you to study within New Zealand, but it also enables you to look at study abroad opportunities. So if you are for an undergraduate course with a New Zealand university, you can look forward to do a study abroad trimester or a semester across the world. And that gives you an opportunity not only about New Zealand, but also aligning you with any of the other countries across the world as well. Student experiences are key for a success of each of the New Zealand universities. So we not only limit yourself on internships, on careers, but there are more than 60 plus clubs in each of the New Zealand universities, and you can become a part of any of those clubs. Most of the universities do have an Indian student community. They love to celebrate the festivals. They love to ensure that you have a connect with the local community or back when you are all the way there. And one very important aspect is a lot of universities focus on alumni engagement. So while you are there, you will have a very strong engagement with alumni who will also support you in how your career shapes up in New Zealand. And that's a very other important piece of how we not only culturally align you with the local community, but we also align you with employers who have a long-term impact to play in the student's life from a career perspective as well. These are some of the snapshots on how the student activities and things look like. A snapshot on the left also gives you an indication on how the student accommodation for you will look like while you are on campus as well. All universities have accommodations which are on campus. And while you decide to accept your offer or decide to accept your place with new universities, you can reach out to the accommodations team. There are halls which are fully catered. You don't need to cook any of your meals. Your meals options will be taken care of. There are self-catered halls where you'll have a kitchen cabinet. You can prepare your own meals as per your own taste and choice. There are independent or accommodation of flatting where you could hire your own service apartment and they're not very far off. You could take it 15, 20 minutes away from the campus. And there's an opportunity to stay with a New Zealand family as well. And those are known as homestay accommodations. And the best part is each university has a very strong supporting mechanism for international students. You can reach out to the accommodation team and they will take care of your needs depending on the kind of accommodation you decide to choose for yourself. I think before I sign off from today's webinar and jump on to interact with you on some of the questions around, which I can see popping in at the chat box. It would be very good to listen to one of our student journey of his experience of coming to New Zealand for a qualification.
Hi, I'm Nicholas Solar from India, and I study screen and media studies. New Zealand is one of the safest countries in the world today, and that's one of the reasons why I'm studying here. When I first arrived, I was dumbfounded by how huge the campus is. I think I was more impressed with my department's facilities and all the equipment that I had access to. So Waikato definitely gave me the ability to learn practically, while also rendering me the space to conceptualize my own projects with continuous support from my professors. Well, there are a ton of opportunities here in New Zealand in the field of media. Most production houses here definitely require skilled cinematographers, skilled media designers, or even directors for that matter. In fact, I myself here work as a media designer for a startup in Hamilton. Well, I would love to work for Weta Digital, but in the meantime, I have been concentrating on setting up my own production house in New Zealand and working as an independent filmmaker. Absolutely love how diverse New Zealand is. I mean, since moving to Waikato, I've made a ton of Kiwi, Fijian, Filipino, Indian, and Cambodian friends. I would definitely recommend studying here. Do come and join me at the University of Waikato.
Happy to jump in with the set of questions. And thank you so much, everyone, for listening. I would say with your patience here at this moment, given that's the afternoon time of the day. Thank you.